My name is Amanda Jo Schreiber. I am a graduate research assistant at the University of Missouri under Dr. Harley Naumann in the Division of Plant Sciences and Technology. I am in the third year of my master's degree with a project focusing on the establishment of native plant species in silvopasture systems for livestock forage. So before I get into the ins and outs of what our research is and what we're doing out here and what we've been doing the past 3 years, I thought I would take a moment to discuss what is silvopasture. I know for some people that is an unfamiliar term, and it's important to understand what that is as I continue to explain what we're doing here and why. So silvopasture is the intentional integration and production of timber, forage, and livestock in one system. So in the same plot of land, you have all three products. It is not, however, just letting your livestock continuously graze in the understory of a forest. So for something to be considered an agroforestry practice, it has to meet four principles of agroforestry, which are socially acceptable, biologically possible, ecologically sustainable, and economically feasible. So now that we've established kind of a basis of what silvopasture is and why somebody would use it, or what are some pros and cons of trying to establish or incorporate silvopasture into your existing system, I'll go into a little more detail of what we're doing here with this project. So as I stated earlier, we are establishing native forage plant species in a silvopasture system. The silvopasture that we are using was already pre-established as far as the tree component, so we are just solely looking at the establishment of a forage component for livestock grazing. The reason we chose natives is more of a novel approach compared to an introduced species is to coincide with the trend of people wanting to become more sustainable and trying to incorporate more diversity into their system through attraction of pollinators or a wildlife habitat, in addition to supporting their grazing animals or their timber production or whatever the venture may be. So we have two types of silvopasture here. There is a pitch loblolly pine that is our conifer treatment, and then black walnut is our deciduous hardwood treatment. And both of these are getting compared to an open pasture control. We have a custom seed mix of various native cool season grasses, warm season grasses, forbs, and legumes that were chosen because they could provide a wildlife habitat, attract pollinators, or provide forage for grazing livestock, which could be cattle, sheep, or goats. Those are the top three choices that people typically use in a rotational grazing system. So we have 23 different species. Three are the cool season grasses, five are the warm season grasses, and the remaining species are all of the forbs and legumes. And we have this large variety because we want to see what environments can establish the different types. Not every species may establish under the pine treatment or vice versa in the walnut treatment. So we wanted to have a variety to see if there were some that established better in one treatment over the other. Our study is split up into two growing seasons. So we had year one establishment and year two establishment. Year one establishment was started in fall of 2019. We no-till drilled the cool season grasses in September. And then after the first frost, we no-till drilled the rest of the plant species so that they could go through that cool period of vernalization that would help with their germination. We repeated this process again for year two in fall and winter of 2020. During the following springs is when we would collect all of our measurements for the environmental data. Another type of measurement that we used was collecting stand counts at the various distances from the tree, and we also measured the percent ground cover and percent competition we have from unwanted species. So things that may have been pre-existing, your weeds, you know, what type of weed pressure were we having on the establishment of our new seedlings. Another final thing that we collected were forage samples that we are analyzing for nutritive value, because we are trying to graze livestock in here, and we want to know, are these native forages going to provide quality nutrition for our grazing animals? So our nutritive analysis will include the different fiber fractions, crude protein, and digestibility of the forages. And all of this information is in the process of being analyzed right now. We're getting ready to wrap up our final year two collections, so that's when all the number crunching and everything goes down. How are we measuring the success of establishment between the different treatments? Well, there's a couple ways we are taking measurements. The first is through environmental data that we are collecting via sensors connected to hobo data loggers. The three types of sensors we are using are collecting information on soil moisture, ambient temperature, and PAR, which is photosynthetically active radiation. And what that does is measures the amount of light that is reaching the soil surface or the growing area underneath the tree canopy. And so what we do with the sensors is we rotate them throughout each of the treatments as well as the control. There's a set out there as well in the open pasture so that we can get a diverse amount of measurements at different distances from the actual line of tree out to the center of the alley, so that if there was any variability in the tree canopy, we have a chance to capture that. Another way we are collecting data is through stand counts and percent plant composition and percent weed pressure. So again, we are taking measurements randomly at different distances from the trees throughout the treatments, counting the number of plants that we are trying to establish, and assigning a percentage based on the amount of plants that we have in the area we're measuring compared to the amount of unwanted species that we didn't or are not attempting to establish. And then lastly, we are trying to establish these native plants for forage for livestock. So we are collecting samples that we are then going to analyze for a nutritive value so that we can have a sense of what type of forage we would be feeding our livestock. So things that we measure in that instance are crude protein, the different fiber fractions, and percent digestibility. As I mentioned before, we are in year three of this project. It started in 2019, and we're getting ready to wrap up the end of year two data collection. And so we're in the process of analyzing all the numbers and everything that we've collected thus far. So what have we learned? What are some general observations that I've seen? Weed pressure is something that will affect your establishment. One of the replications that we have, so we have three replications of each of the two treatments, as well as three replications in the control. One of the replications was used for overwintering livestock. That replication tended to have a larger weed pressure affecting the younger seedlings compared to the other two reps. So that was something that we visibly noticed. Something else to take note of is that in the first year, we didn't see a lot of the warm seasons and forbs and legumes coming up. There was plenty of the rye, but it's like those things were missing from the system, you know? Yeah, it was like, did we plant them? Patience. Patience is something that we have to account for, because we went back and took measurements from the first year at the beginning of this spring, and all of the forbs had started coming up, and we were starting to see warm season grasses. Even the cool season grass was thicker the second time around. So it's just something that takes time. You may not see instant results when you first plant that first fall, but be patient. Another thing to take note of is that we don't have any grazing animals on our system at this time. We are purely looking at the establishment of the forage itself, and therefore have not grazed any of our paddocks. The only management tool we have used rather than grazing animals is mowing. At the end of this video, I've included a list of references for further information on how one can go about establishing a silvopasture, either as a new or into an existing pasture system.